Welcome to our video on the cloning technique Gibson assembly. This video covers four tips to improve your success using Gibson assembly. Tip 1. As with other PCR-based cloning techniques, success with Gibson assembly starts with thoughtful primer design. There are two important regions to consider in your PCR primers: the region that binds to your template and the region that will overlap with your cloning vector or adjacent fragment. There is not always flexibility in selecting overlap regions, but if possible, avoid regions that can form secondary structures. Tip 2. Optimize your PCR reactions to minimize mutations and artifacts. Use a high-fidelity PCR polymerase for any PCR-based cloning technique and keep rounds of PCR to a minimum, as each additional round of PCR will increase the frequency of mutated fragments in your final product. In addition, optimize reaction conditions so that there are minimal subbands or PCR artifacts present in your PCR reactions. And finally, set your annealing temperature based on the target-specific portion of your primers. Tip 3. Pay attention to quantities. Each manufacturer provides slightly different instructions regarding how much of each fragment to use. In general, the recommendation is for 2 copies of fragment per copy of vector. Multi-fragment assemblies have their own recommendations. Note that the guidelines are not just for molar ratios, but also for the total mass of DNA added to the reaction. Tip 4. Prevent or select against background colonies. PCR fragments created for Gibson assembly may use a template plasmid. If the template plasmid is carried through the reaction, it can result in background colonies. Preventing background colony growth is particularly important if you have chosen to use inverse PCR to prepare your cloning vector. You can prevent this in one of 2 ways: either by gel purifying your PCR product band, or by adding DPN1 to your complete PCR reactions. DPN1 only digests methylated DNA, and therefore will digest plasmid extracted from most bacteria. PCR-amplified DNA is unmethylated, thus it will not be cut during DPN1 digestion. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.